How have I gone this long without talking about Cowboy Bebop? Cowboy Bebop is one of the most iconic, impactful, and influential anime to ever be created. One of, if not the biggest reasons for its popularity, is its beloved main character, Spike Spiegel. The coolest man in any room you might just so happen to be in. Spike's laid-back, unassuming exterior, masking his inner pain and turmoil, has become one of the most prevalent character archetypes in anime since its introduction all those years ago. There's nothing dumb nerds like myself love more than a wild-haired, lazy, badass main character who can talk, whoop ass, and make it all look totally effortless. Spike is the epitome of cool, but his amount of cool is not the only thing that fans of the show resonate with. He's also a man who unapologetically lives by his own set of rules and principles. He does things his way, regardless of what others think or tell him to do. He stands up for people who have been shunned by others, and he's never one to shy away from a challenge. He's also unafraid of taking risks because he believes in his intuition and his ability to come through in the end. Simply put, Spike Spiegel is an amazing character, and in a lot of ways, despite him being just a fictional drawing that I watched through a screen, Spike Spiegel is a true role model, a personal ideal. He's someone that we could all strive to be a little bit more like in our own lives. Spike is one of my favorite anime characters of all time, which is why it's always been weird to me that when it comes to his backstory, I could not give less of a fuck.
But I don't care.
We do not care.
Don't care. Don't care. Don't care. Still don't care. I don't care.
Maybe I'm in the minority on this. I don't know for sure, but every time I watch Cowboy Bebop and I get to an episode about Spike's backstory and the Syndicate and Virgil McSephiroth over here with the crow pet on his shoulder, I just kinda check out. Like, I've watched this series like 2, maybe 3 times now, and I still don't have a great grasp on the Syndicate and their full role in the plot, and I don't really care if I ever do learn about them. Their presence is pretty much just a really boring nuisance to me, and they only really serve to take away from the other, much greater, aspects of Bebop, in my opinion. I get that Bebop needed some kind of overarching villainous threat that seeps its way into all of the other characters' stories, but God, I just wish it was more interesting or fleshed out. And then there's Julia, Spike's love interest and the main motivation for his character. She gets less screen time than the goddamn dog. Rightfully so, because Ayn is adorable AF. And like 5 minutes after she finally gets introduced into the story, oh, there she goes, shot and killed, gone forever. Poor Spike. Didn't even get a chance to tell her about the amazing Edward. I think if we were shown more of Spike and Julia's connection, like what made them fall in love or what that love looked like, then her murder might have actually hit harder and I might have actually cared when she got clapped. But because the writers didn't do any of that, Julia's entire character feels like a poorly developed excuse to have Spike clash with Vicious in the end. And even that final confrontation with Vicious is pretty lackluster as far as a main character of a story's final confrontation with their mortal enemy goes. It all just feels kinda meh. And it doesn't feel like a backstory and a plot deserving of a character as great and as interesting as Spike. As much as I do like Cowboy Bebop and fully recognize and respect its status as one of the most important anime to ever be created, I gotta say that the show doesn't really become great to me until around episode 9, which is coincidentally when Edward comes into the picture and we finally get the full group all together. I have a lot of conflicting feelings and opinions about Bebop as a whole, but I think my issues with Spike serve as a pretty fitting microcosm of those broader issues. What disappoints me most about Spike is that Cowboy Bebop feels like such a refreshing and unique show, but Spike's backstory feels so generic and by the numbers. And I get that no matter how unique Bebop may seem, it is based off of those old cliche cowboy westerns of the past. And those films have their own specific tried and true formulas, character archetypes, and plot structures, much like a modern Marvel movie. I think if Spike's backstory had only been at the core of maybe a couple episodes like Jet's and Faye's backstories were, then I wouldn't have such a huge problem with it, but of course, Spike's bland-ass origin story ends up being the crux of the entire finale and the overarching plot of the entire show. It just leaves a really shitty taste in my mouth whenever I think about Cowboy Bebop and Spike's role in it. I understand that this would involve almost completely rewriting the show, but I actually wish Faye's backstory and her tragic journey of trying to uncover her past and regain her memories was the core of the narrative, and especially the finale. Her story just had so many more impactful and memorable moments for me. I also just happen to think that the concept of a tragically unlucky femme fatale catapulted into a bizarre future with no memories of her past while having an obscene debt to repay is kind of objectively more interesting and entertaining than badass ex-con searches the cosmos for forbidden love in space. Jet's backstory also has its cliches, but I guess those episodes just feel like they're better written than Spike's, so I'm not nearly as turned off by his backstory. But as shitty as it is that Bebop missed out on reaching its full potential because of how it fumbled Spike's origin, it does highlight an interesting point about storytelling and character writing that I think is pretty crucial. Backstories don't really matter. Or at least, they don't have to matter. I think in anime especially, writers and fans get a little too preoccupied with the character's past that made them who they are, as opposed to just appreciating who they are regardless of what led them to that point. Like, Seto Kaiba is a great antagonist in Yu-Gi-Oh! Because of the unbelievably sinister and savage things he does and says in the present of the series. Knowing that he was a genius orphan who was adopted by an abusive rich scumbag, I guess explains his actions, but it doesn't really enhance my enjoyment of watching him operate and ruthlessly talk his Mugen from Samurai Champloo has a tragic backstory, but the audience isn't even shown that until halfway through the series. And I think by then, anyone watching the show would have made up their mind about liking or not liking Mugen from the info we were already given. And who the f*** doesn't like Mugen? But there definitely are characters that are made better by the audience knowing their backstories, like Naruto or Itachi and pretty much every other good character from Naruto, but I completely resent the idea that all good characters need to have good backstories. Look at most of the villains from My Hero Academia. I mean, a lot of them have pretty interesting backstories, but most of them are also awful characters that annoy the fuck out of me every time I see them. Backstories can definitely affect the quality of a character, but there are many other, much more important factors like personality, objective, and look, among others, that truly determine a character's worth. Spike is one of the best characters with, in my opinion, one of the absolute worst backstories. And many people, including myself, still love him despite that. And that's because what he lacks in his past, he more than makes up for what is shown in his present. And fittingly for Spike Spiegel, that's some cool shit. All this talk of anime backstories got me thinking. Why is it so hard for people to escape their past? Obviously, not all of us have pasts that we want to separate ourselves from, but for most people, there's at least some aspect of our upbringing that we want to disassociate from. Whether it was some form of abuse, inadequacy, failure, there's always that fear that comes along with those demons of our past that can make us think we'll never outgrow them. To anyone who may be grappling with those fears now, I want you to know that you are more than what your past has made you. You're an entire future of unwritten possibilities. You shouldn't forget your past, but don't become trapped in it either. Don't be afraid to ask yourself what you want and how you want to attain it. As long as you're alive, you're free to choose your own fate. So take it all into consideration, your past, present, and your future. Then learn to live free of all of them. None of your mistakes, none of your misfortunes, none of your misdeeds have to define you. Spike only lived the facade of freedom. In reality, he was never able to sever his connection to his painful past. As much as I, and I'm sure a lot of you watching this, would want to be like Spike in a lot of ways, no one is perfect, and we have an opportunity to be better than Spike. We have the opportunity to live completely unrestrained by our backstories, and instead, live our lives as whoever the hell we want to be. I hope you take that opportunity every chance you get.